Like, this just feels weird, though. Look at how many units are on my freaking screen right now. Well, hello there, everybody. Dre here, and today we're gonna watch thousands, maybe even hundreds of thousands of little tiny men fight to the death for our viewing pleasure, because we're playing Epic Fantasy Battle Simulator. So yes, this is another battle simulator. I honestly don't check many out these days because they all kind of suck. But I decided to install this one. It just came out, and I gotta say, it actually feels pretty good. I feel like the scale of battles is going to get absolutely insane. So instead of talking about it, let's just get into it and do a simple battle here. So we got some swordsmen. We're just going to put down, and I really like the way they do this, so it's in lines, but we can put down 50 good men, and then we can actually expand that out to whatever we want. Let's try 1,000, and you know what? Let's do something a little bit bigger, like an oak tree. This has 10,000 HP. So yeah, a hell of a lot more than those men, so let's just see if they can do... Let's do a good team of like 15. Oh, no, not that many. 15. But yeah, I kind of want to see how crazy we can get with these things. We can also possess if we do want to. So yeah, I'm going to possess this guy. And we are going in. Okay, I think I kind of one-sided this. Interestingly enough, I don't hear the audio. I did hear the audio before. Oh, there we go. Okay, I just have to go to the menu. I'm just swiping hundreds of humans. Yeah, I didn't think the trees or the ents, whatever you want to call them, would be this strong. But with this swipe attack, they can't even get in range. I'm just literally taking out like 15 at a time. I think we got to give these guys some help. All right, so we'll do a pretty huge team. This is going to be probably victorious for the humans, but I mean, you never know. Yeah, I don't know why those guys spawn backwards. There we go. Now the sound's on, though. Oh, dude, look at this. And this is why I like this one so much. It actually looks good. I'm not lagging at all yet, so we're going to be able to get into absolutely insane scale. Don't think the spears are going to help too much with that attack, but the arrows, I think, will actually... Oh! Oh, okay. Well, we have our first few down. They are going down really quickly. I think it's mostly due to the arrow damage. Seems like bows in this game actually have quite a bit of range, which is not good news for my few ends left, but good news for the humans. It looks like the humans did win after all. We have two more that need to go down. Dude, the scale of these are actually pretty cool as well. And yes, there we go. Oh my God. Okay, clearly I spawned too many bowmen. But yeah, that was more of a large scale battle. So let's try something new here. We have other options. There's not a lot of units just yet, but we do have the orcs as well. So maybe we should do like a human versus orc battle. So I think this valley would be a really cool spot for a big battle where humans are outnumbered. So what we're going to do is literally try and hold the valley. There we go. We're going to do 950 strong, hopefully holding this out. And at the top, we definitely want the humans to be outnumbered, but we want them to have the upper hand with the terrain, which is exactly why I'm fighting here. This will be a good choke point. So it's about 1,500 strong, it looks like, give or take a bit. Now let's do the orcs, which we will do a hell of a lot more. So yeah, we'll have the slashers going in first, and we'll do let's even do 1,500 of those strong. I want to see how big we can get these battles. Actually, in front of them, we'll do a bunch of spearmen. You always want spears in the front. And then we want some bowmen as well, so we're going to throw quite a few of those on just to give them a chance. I think that should be good. You know what? Let's throw one ogre in the middle, just as like the captain or something. All right, so I'm gonna get the second team of spearmen to hold. The first one will attack to keep them busy. The bowmen, obviously, we want to hold as well. And this should be a pretty interesting fight. Here we go. Any lag? Doesn't look like it. Oh, dude, did we just knock down? Wow, archers are almost too good, I think. We knocked down so many of them. Here we go. We have the spearmen battling with the skewers in the front. Looks like some are getting over to the side, which is going to overrun these guys pretty quickly. But that's why we have this line of defense. I think the humans might win this just due to their advantage with the terrain, especially considering how deadly these archers are. But yeah, I'm not seeing any archers that are dead down here. It looks like the ogres have made it to the line of defense. If they can break this line of defense, obviously the archers are going to have a bad time. We still have the giant ogre trying to get through his brethren. Oh my God, look at that gut. He might actually die just due to the archers. Oh, there we go. He's finally getting his little club off and definitely not doing as much damage as the ant, but he is taking out multiples and he's down. This isn't looking good. It's close though. We definitely have quite a few. This is going to be a close battle over here. We've spread into two different battles, as you can see, but the orcs are definitely dwindling their numbers. Actually, yeah, it looks like they're going to be overrun here. They still have all their archers, but that's not going to last too long, I don't think. Okay, actually, orcs have been taking out this side archers, as you can see. They've been targeting them. And there goes... We have one man running away left. I don't blame you, buddy. I told you to hold. He's dodging arrows right now. That's actually some pretty good aim. Well, I didn't think about this. When I told them to hold, I didn't think they'd literally hold the whole time. I thought if they get attacked, they'd actually go in. I think we're going to be at a standstill here because these guys are possibly out of range. And these guys, because I told them to hold, are not moving towards the enemies. Actually, this is going to be close. They actually are in range of these guys. They just target whatever's closest. Humans are indeed hitting them now, but it's not at an angle where they're going to kill a lot of them. And these guys are being depleted rapidly, so... I don't know who's gonna win this. This is good. Well, man, I told you to hold out, and you listened to me maybe a little too literally, but god damn it. I can't lie. You guys have some pretty big balls, and there we go. Okay, this is where it's gonna get interesting, because the way these guys are angled, they're gonna be able to take down a lot of them if they can actually hit them. Let's see. Oh, yeah, this... Oh, did they block it? No, they do get hit in the back. The interesting part is up front. I think they might be safe. Never mind. I think they are actually gonna win just due to this crazy angle where they can take out a bunch of them. All right, you're gonna be totally fine, buddy. You're the last one in the back. Okay, I totally lied. I'm sorry. And there goes the final of them. Congrats to the orcs winning it after all. Gotta say, I don't think they would have won if the hold thing didn't happen, but still, that was a close fight, and that's all I want in this game. All right, I'm really enjoying the archery, so let's try and make Death Valley here once again. But this time, I want to go big scale. I want to see what this game can truly handle. We're just going to get a zerg of orcs. Orc slashers, we'll do a bunch of them. Dude, that looks weird. We didn't use any orc destroyers last time, so let's throw a few of those guys in. Looks like we can overlap, so that's cool. And just because I want the humans to lose and I just want to test this... We're going to add another, let's do 34,000 over here. And that's just to make sure they die. I mean, they can't kill all of this, right? All right, and here we go. It looks like, so they break off into different types of platoons, it looks like, because there's different squares you can see. Each is, I guess, probably considered one unit where they all just follow the same line. Amazingly, obviously, I'm getting a little bit of lag. But not as much as I expected. Looks like this team actually decided to go over here. I was hoping they wouldn't do that, but that's fine. We are all split up. All right, well, we do have them going in. It looks like these guys are going to be rapidly destroyed. Mind you, these guys got a really good shot. As you can see, even if they get within range, looks like their defenses are pretty decent as well. Okay, I thought once we got in range, these guys would be dead. Not looking good, man. Not looking good for the orcs. There's still a lot on the battlefield, but they don't all run at the same time. They kind of just hold out here and wait and queue, and that's what's really killing them. We got a lot over here now, though. Okay, this might be their chance. See, the thing is, it's just strength in numbers. It looks like they're being destroyed because they're in such small platoons, but there's just so many of them. So they're being hit from over here. Still a crap load in the middle. And these guys are being constantly hit, but they're not really losing too much, as you can see. Well, there we go. The humans officially have more units than the orcs left, so that's definitely not going to work for them. As you can see at the top, they're rapidly going down. It's all just due to pathing, though. The pathing is really not the best. We have this giant traffic jam here, as you can see, so they're slowly just trickling in. And with how accurate these archers are, we need them to be overwhelmed really, really quickly. So this side, they actually did pretty good. Quite a few... I mean, it definitely doesn't look like it, but they did get pushed back. Quite a few were lost. Thing is, I mean, this side is where the vast majority of them are. Totally fine. They're just chilling over here, just waiting. And we still, well, we did have a big Zerg in the middle. Looks like, yeah, these guys are still here. This is not enough to do anything, though. As you can see, we're down to 9,000 now, so I'm just going to accept defeat. And yeah, I think I'm going to stick to flatland here. I feel like using the terrain just makes pathing weird. It'd be cool to see a big-scaled fight like that just in the open here. Let's actually do that, just orcs versus humans. All right, so we're not going to go too crazy with the archers because we've learned how just disastrous they are. So I tried to make the teams as even as possible. As you can see, I kept the unit counts comparable on each side depending on which unit it is. So yeah, we're just going to move over to team two, put everybody on attack, even the archers. And yeah, this should be a pretty even fight, all things considered. So here we go. This is too many units to be... I mean, I'm at 23 FPS. That's not great, but it's not unwatchable. And just the sheer scale of this is freaking insane. Like, look at this. Let's actually go to the cinematic camera. Oh, that just gets rid of everything. Okay, I didn't know if it was like a unique camera or whatnot. So we got a pretty crazy front line here. I do like the sound effects. I will say that. It is a very nice sounding game. Yeah, the front line is just... insane all the way across. Is anybody gonna wrap around, or are we not that strategic? It doesn't look like we're that strategic. So I have no idea who's winning right now, but this is just gonna be a giant tug of war essentially. Look at, how are these archers hitting, but they're not? Their range must be lower. Like, this just feels weird though. Look at how many units are on my freaking screen right now. It looks like the humans are pushing ahead. Obviously, we have death behind the front line. So right now, I'd say the humans are winning. Hard to say if that will keep up, though. All right, just from watching, it's looking like the orcs definitely have the lower hand right now, as you can just tell by the size difference. I mean, all the orcs are green. The humans are red and blue mostly. Let's actually just check the stats here. Ooh, it's closer than I thought, 21 to 29,000. But yeah, the orcs are rapidly going down, and I mean, it's just these archers, man. Honestly, I should just keep the archers off. They do so much freaking damage. There's just a rain of freaking arrows here. There's only 3,000 archers on each side, which sounds like a lot, but when we're talking about the scale of this battle, really not that much. We have made it to the shieldmen, though, so the first line of defense has been totally destroyed. Hopefully these guys, because the further we go back, the stronger they get. Hopefully these orcs will be a lot stronger. But yeah, I think they're just going to be overwhelmed at this point. We're at 16 to 25,000. They might pick up, though. You never know. These units might be disastrous at the back. So obviously, I don't know if you saw, but we can slow down speed if we want to. As with all these games, we can even pause it, which is nice. But also, what I like is we can speed it up. You can actually really speed it up, which is great for these large battles where you just don't want to stand here forever. And that's why I'm doing it exactly now. Okay, yeah, it's looking like the last line of the orc defense is being wiped out. They held out pretty good, though, down to 19,000 humans. There they go, and the poor archers. What are you guys doing? Run to the archers. I think there was a few units there just kind of screwing them up. And there's the last little bit of them. It's so weird and super fast-paced. How many were left? 15,000. So, I mean, quite a few. Humans absolutely destroyed that. All right, the only unit we haven't tried is the Demon Lord. So I'm going to do... I want to do a pretty big fight here. These guys are obviously disastrous. We'll do six. And let's just see how many humans this is going to take. I'm going to start pretty crazy here, but I think we're going to probably need it. All right, demons, let's see what you got. I don't think it's going to be good for you. Mind you, those archers finally freaking miss. Let's see that attack. Oh, I thought it was beat their whip. Okay, it is their whip kind of. It's just kind of a weird animation. They are going to take a crap load of damage, though. You know what? Let's actually possess one of these guys. There we go. Just to see how much HP they have. And yeah, it's not looking good. I'm going to try and help the best I can. Oh, I didn't even know that was a sword. Okay. Yeah, I'm dying. I'm just trying to get away from them because the archers are pretty much targeting them. There I go. There goes everybody. How many do we have left? 5,000? Okay, that means we can definitely have a few more. So we'll double it to 12 Demon Lords. I also removed the Bowmen just to see how much they indeed help. Ah, here comes the big boys. Oh, they just got absolutely destroyed. Yeah, I think the demons have this. Again, they all could be low, though. But There's not many humans left. Oh, we do have a demon down. That means all of them are probably pretty low health. This could get interesting here. It could be closer than I thought. Oh, man, this is bad. We're down to, what, four demons? This guy just got absolutely destroyed. And there's the final little bit. They were fighting something else. I think the humans win, but just. Come on, demons, you can hold out. You're probably extremely low HP. Take out a few more. There goes one. We have one final demon left. Yeah, he's not taking out 2,000 units. That's for damn sure. And there he goes. Humans are victorious after all. All right, guys, and on that, we're just going to wrap up this episode here. I just wanted to quickly show you guys this game as it just came out. Obviously, it's still very much new, but I do like the placement mechanics. The fights are pretty decent. The pathing could be improved in this game, but aside from that, I mean, it doesn't seem to lag at all. And yeah, if you like large-scale warfare, well, this is a good option for that. So yeah, as always, guys, thanks for watching and liking, and I'll see you in the next one.